So we're going to talk about common insecticides, but before we do that, when should we use insecticides?
Use insecticides when the threshold is reached that you need to use them. And I say that because I always like to give beneficial insects a chance to take out my bad bugs. Mm-hmm. And there's a predator-prey relationship that exists that means the prey has to be available before the predator can thrive. With many insects, there are economic thresholds. With aesthetic plants, there are aesthetic thresholds. You know, how much damage can you live with?
Yeah, that's what I was asking.
Before you need to go in there the big guns and take them out. So I would, and in many cases, I know on agricultural crops, there are economic thresholds that exist, and the folks that go out and scout agricultural crops, they'll go out and they count insects. Pecans, you count insects, and when it reaches a point, it gets to a certain number, that triggers an insecticide application. So it's when the numbers get high enough that you really need to spray.
That's good.
Many times, most of the times, aphid numbers will get up to a high enough level that, of course, you've got lace bugs and there are a lot of beneficial insects that feed on aphids, but they're also, they can reach a certain level where they get a disease and they die. They just die off.
Okay.
So that's when you apply an insecticide.
So that's when you apply. So now let's talk about those common insecticides that we have out there.
Common insecticides, and I like to go with as gentle a product as I can, the easiest on the environment as I can first.
Okay.
And that means the biologicals. But the most common biological insecticide is BT, mm-hmm. Bacillus thuringiensis. It's been around a long time.
All right.
And it works mostly on caterpillars. It'll work on your tomato hornworm, tomato fruit worm, tobacco hornworm, cabbage loopers, a lot of your vegetable insects, bagworms to get on your ornamentals, army worms. It'll give you some control of army worms.
That's right.
But if it's a caterpillar, you know, most caterpillars are controlled by BT. There are some that are not. Another biological is clarified neem oil, and it does a pretty good job on aphids. Mm-hmm. Also will work on armyworms, but it also take out some beetles, scales, spider mites, and white flies.
Okay.
Now, if BT doesn't do the trick, two of the oldest and most common insecticides, Carbaryl and Malathion. Carbaryl is known for working on insects with chewing mouth parts, and it still does a pretty good job on a lot of the worms. Most of the worm caterpillars have chewing mouth parts.
Yeah.
So you're talking about army worms, bean leaf beetles, corn ear worms, European corn borer, Japanese beetles, cabbage worm, Mexican bean beetle, and I already mentioned hornworms. Malathion is known for working on insects that have piercing, sucking mouth parts. And so they do a better job on aphids, some of the immature scale insects. Leaf bugs, plant bugs, maybe stink bugs, squash bugs. And
those are tough,
Thrips, and even white flies and things like that. So those are some of your old standbys. Unfortunately, especially with Carbaryl, there are some insects that have developed a resistance, somewhat of a resistance to some of those older ones. Little hotter products, Pyrethrum, is a naturally occurring insecticide made from chrysanthemums.
Right.
And it is extremely hot, and it will take care of all of those insects that I mentioned that Carbaryl will take care of. Starting, I guess, in the 80s, late 70s and 80s, a synthetic pyrethroid was developed, which is a synthetic pyrethrum. And these are Bifenthrin, beta sapermethrin, Cyfluthrin, esfenvalerate, Permethrin. You know, you see how it can be kind of confusing. But those are all synthetic pyrethroids. And they will control all of the insects that the pyrethrins control. But they have a little bit longer life in the environment.
Right.
They'll last a little bit longer.
Residual.
And they're probably a little bit cheaper than this. They're probably easier to synthesize than and cheaper to synthesize than the pyrethrins from the chrysanthemum.
Okay.
But they are very, very common and commonly recommended for spider control in your houses.
Yeah.
And a lot of the harder to kill insect like stink bugs, they will give you a little bit better control on stink bugs, squash bugs.
Yeah.
Right now, they're probably the most common insecticide. Also flying insect killers, you know, they the wasp killers and bee killers, they all have the synthetic pyrethroids on them. Insecticidal soaps is something that does a pretty good job on scale insects and some aphids,
soft-bodied
things
insects.
Like that.
Yeah.
That'll give you some help with white flies, even the larvae of white flies, especially spider mites. It may you know they may smother anything that can clog up and smother breathing tubes, and then soaps will do that, give you a little bit of that. Horticultural oils are also good for aphids and beetle larvae, Colorado potato beetle larvae, leafhoppers, and leaf miner, scale thrips, and white flies. Spinosads are—that's a microbial or biological, another biological that does an amazingly good job on army worms, caterpillars, Colorado potato beetle, diamondback moth, European corn borer, flea beetles, imported cabbage worm, leaf miners, and loopers. So that's another one that, if you're organically minded.
How do you know which one of those insecticides to use for your situation?
Read that label. That label is a document that a lot of work has gone into. If it's a caterpillar, if it's a worm, if it's a caterpillar, I'm going to throw dipel at it first.
Right.
Dipel, that's a trade name, one trade name, the old trade name for Bacillus thuringiensis, BT. If it's got piercing, sucking mouth parts, if it's an aphid, sucking the juices out of my plants, I'm going to throw Malathion at it.
Right.
You know, I go at it at that angle. If it's a brown recluse spider, I'm going to do a little research, and I'm going to see which one of those synthetic pyrethroids is going to do the trick. Probably going to be Bifenthrin there or something like that.
Yeah.
So identify your problem.
That's key.
And then do a little research, make sure it's on the label.
Right.
Just because it's on the label doesn't necessarily mean it is the best product.
Right. Got it.
One thing, almost all of these insecticides, with the exception of BT, will kill honeybees and pollinating insects. So if you have a lot of blooming plants and don't spray the blooms. Wait until after bloom if you can to use these insecticides.
That's good stuff, Mr. D. And I will add this, if you see the aphids out there, maybe some water and knock them off sometimes. You don't always have to go grab the insecticide off the shelf.
That's right. Give that lace wing, that lace, the chance to come in there and take them out.
All right. Thank you, Mr. D. That's good information, man. We appreciate that.